Alright, this is a bit of a mixed video. It'll be a little bit about... There is a pangolin that is on the PBS, and I believe everybody needs to watch this little creature. It's named Honey Bun. Now, Honey Bun was a baby pangolin that was born in captivity. The mother was in a traumatic situation, and she was rescued, and then had the little baby Honey Bun. The mother ran away after. It was a very bad situation for her. She couldn't stay even in captivity. So this is all going on in South Africa. Now this Honey Bun, though, is then there raised. There's the woman, I don't have her name, she was wonderful, but she raised Honey Bun from the little baby and up through, lived in the house, etc., etc. And then she also brought such an importance to the pangolin rescue that they built a rescue center there in South Africa for them. Apparently 100,000 a year are killed, and they are sold off to the Asians, who use them in their medicines. They take the scales off of them. They even eat them also. So they have gone too far, because these are the little wonderfuls that crawl around in a little swirl. They're very calm, they're docile, they're loving creatures. They walk on two legs, just as we walk on two legs. So they are one of the most unique links to us and human that exist here on this planet. Anything that is an animal walking on two legs is incredible. It is something that is just like, wow, like our cousin. It doesn't look like our cousin, but oh my goodness, he's walking on two legs. Very unusual. So this little creature, then after in the show, I'm loving PBS at the moment. They put this show out there. It's very good for them. They need to be accoladed. We need more shows like this, because it's one that just gives the juice out there and tells people what's going on. I had no idea that they were taking that many out of captivity. I mean, out of the wild, and eating them, and putting them, and then stealing their scales. I mean, it's just horrible. Horrible thing. Like, more, we're saying that it's higher now than the ivory tusks. It has become such on a high scale. Yeah, pardon the pun, but yeah, they have scaled bodies. Okay, so the only thing, the clincher at the end of the PBS show is Honey Bun was released. And I'm like, no. You know, she just seemed so like your household dog, like really like, you know, there, just, hello, I'm out there, and then I run back to you because I need a snuggle. Is this type of animal? And so if it's running back to you because it needs a little snuggle, how could you put it out there in the wild? So for me, it's a bit of a controversy. I would have kept Honey Bun and not let her have the wild. Maybe, you know, let her have more of her space around the compound, and then maybe try to get a mate right there. But I don't know, to go and put her out on the wild like that all by themselves, you know, it just seems a little harsh. A harsh treatment, and one also risky, considering that they are at such a high state of decimation. It seemed a little risky to me. Yeah. Because my ducks, like when I raised them, I tried not to snuggle them, you know, and hope that they were going to fly one day, but they're non-flying ducks, and so they can only fly so far, and you know, so, but I still tried to raise them wild, so they had chances against foxes and other animals. In the heat of the moment, they would have more of a chance. Yeah. anyway, I it's tough though. Once you bring them in the house and they're used to you and they're acclimated and they're eating cereal or whatever, you know, it just seems a little odd to put them out there in the wild. There's almost like that barrier that's like, well, I don't know. So this one's gotten a little too cozy and huggy, you know, once you start hugging it and packing it around all the time, isn't it gonna be like, what's the deal? Aren't I missing that? I mean, how could I be wild now when I was just being packed around and taken on walks for 6 hours a day? I don't understand it, you know. So there's gonna be a lot of confusion going on in the head of that animal, I think. See, with my ducks, I kept them strict. Like, no, I didn't. I rarely ever held them. Maybe once or twice, and that was only when I was moving. So the duck, when you hold an animal like that, and you want to keep it wild, that's part of the key. You know, once you start touching it and handling it, and it becomes your pet, domesticated, extra, like, you know. It's just like part of you, you know, and it's almost like your child, and so how can you? I mean, even with my ducks, they were like my children, even though I kept them at bay. You know what I'm saying? So I don't understand how she, the woman on the show, could distance herself and drop them and say, drop Honeybun and say, no, no more. But absolutely a must-see for everybody. I think it's an eye-opener. It's a congratulations to PBS. Very, very responsible television. I'm very proud of them. Very proud of them for airing that and having that on their television series. So it's just the one show, but that's just really where I was barreling into. This conversation was about honorable professions. Okay, what is an honorable profession? And that woman made an honorable profession. Okay, she made one. She went and she created that rescue center against all the odds of the evils that are taking and stealing and killing those purely docile, calm animals. They don't even have fight instinct. They don't have a fight instinct. They only roll into a ball. I mean, this is impossible. Impossible that they would be stolen to be eaten and stolen from their lives to be some kind of medicine for Asia. But it happens. Okay, so honorable professions, how can we relegate those to be the only ones? Honorable professions, the only professions that are allowed. How can we make that the key to the future? How can we make that the key to going forward? Where dishonorable professions are the ones where they are skinning a rabbit alive, essentially, stretching him out, cutting, bleeding him down for the angora. That is a dishonorable profession. Okay, so we need these types of obvious re-brought back into the entire planet, because apparently it's been forgotten we know the Eastern world, but the Western world is supposed to know better. You know, we may be fighting this East Asia conflict with the animals for some time, but the Western world is supposed to know better. They're supposed to know that you don't stretch a rabbit out and try to skin the angora off of it and while it's squealing. They're supposed to know better, that is a dishonorable profession. And yet these people go to work and do these things. Now, if they're going to work and doing these things and these are classed as a profession, I'm sorry, how could they live their life? How can they go on every day? For me, it is death. If I had that as my only choice and my only option, I would kill myself. Absolutely. That is not a reason for living. When you choose a dishonorable profession, one that tortures animals, one that abuses them, one that causes them abject pain, then you have no right to live. You have no right to choose that profession. You have the choice. You have the choice. And that's the problem. That is absolutely the problem. We have people out there that are choosing these professions. And they're not honorable. So, how do we make a list? We need to make a list. These are the dishonorable professions. These are honorable professions. How do we make that list? You know, what are you going to be when you grow up? You pick that dishonorable list, you are worthy of nothing. You are worthy of nothing. Do you understand? I know it. As a young girl, I wore the Angora sweaters, you know, that was the fashion, the mode. But we have changed, we have adapted, we have modified, we know better now. Okay? Just as the mohair, we're finding out more and more. I got some, they were like some mohair Angora slippers, they were from alpaca. They were alpaca. And I got them when I was in Ireland, and they were just beautiful, you know, on the picture before I purchased them, and then when they arrived in the mail, I was like, oh no, you know, they were really skinned, they were really killed, they were killed for those shoes. They were baby alpacas, baby. So, yeah, I mean, these things are going on, and it's very simple. You just see that on the internet, and it's like, oh, that looks so beautiful, and I figure alpaca is just the wool, you know, that they wear those serape things all the time. And it was looking like that sheep, the New Zealand sheep slippers. But no, it was the baby alpacas. They actually are raising them down there, and it was like Peru or Argentina where I got them from, and they are raising them. And they are babies, and they are killing them because it's so soft at that age, isn't it? It's just so soft. So it was their skin on those shoes. Just horrible. Just a horrible. Anyway, so that's dishonorable, okay? So we have this list now. We have to make these obvious. Are you a dishonorable job or profession, or are you an honorable profession? And I really mean, I'm talking about the animals here. I was so happy today. I went to the Walmart and I saw the flaxseed, and it was there for $2.59 or something, you know, for everybody to buy. So wonderful. That type of thing is filtering in to the big stores. So good for that. You can buy some cheap flax seed. That's not organic, but good. You know? Anyway. Yeah, the honorable or the dishonorable. But if that's it, you know, somebody's gonna say that's it, you have dishonorable or you die. I'll die. And that's the way it goes. I'll kill myself rather than have a dishonorable profession. So that's the way it goes. And who are these people? Who are these people who keep choosing them? Just make them go away, you know. Just make them go away. They're the same people who even buy guns, who go out there and shoot one bear as a trophy. They're the same people. They're the same nasty human beings. So there's so many on that list of dishonorable. There are so many that are taking those professions, and that includes experimenting scientists on animals. Yes, you're dishonorable. I don't care if you think you're going to come up with the cure for cancer. You're a liar. You haven't. You have not even gone anywhere close. All you're still doing is still hacking away at the body and watching it bounce around somewhere else. So you can go to hell, all of you experimentals. Anyway, yeah, baby alpacas.